The Cultural Center of the Philippines is launching its game development, animation, and webcomics grant this month in a bid to boost the Philippine creative economy. What is the potential? Joining us this morning, CCP Board of Trustees member Benedict Carandang and the president of animation studio Tuldok, Rianne Hill Soriano. Rianne, Benedict, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Good morning, Michelle.
All right. So I want to start with Benedict. Benedict, give us the elevator pitch for the CCP grant. Who are qualified? Exactly how much is at stake?
So basically, the Board of Trustees of the CCP earmarked around 20 million pesos worth of grants to support the animation, comics, and computer game sector. So we will have around 1.5 million potential grants for computer games. It will be based on the CCP Encyclopedia of Philippine Art. For animation, there's going to be a grant of up to 2 million pesos. And for comics, around 330,000 pesos. Mm-hmm. So this is going to be a competition. So this is the first time, actually, the government is supporting this kind of program. Because if you notice, there's a trend right now towards Netflix and digitalization efforts. So it's really high time for the government to pursue supporting these creative industries.
I was going to ask why the move to animation, comics, and computer games?
If you notice right now, so we need to be relevant for the new generation. So for the cultural center to be to stay relevant, we have to drive traffic, not just on the physical edifice, mm-hmm. like the building at the back of me, but also on the online platforms. Mm-hmm. So the goal right now is to move towards ACG sectors.
All right. Rianne, you have a very interesting vantage point. How deep is the talent pool? How many artists are we talking about who are into this sort of creative art?
Well, in the case of Tuldok Animation, we are within a few dozens, although the most active right now is about a dozen. Mm-hmm. Specifically, those who are currently engaged in this project called RISE, which is part of the CCP Innovation Grant. So we have a small group for the comics, a small group for the two animated films. So currently, probably about 12 to 15 people are quite active right now because of this project.
Do you have an idea, Rianne, how big the universe is, including Tuldok and outside of Tuldok? How big is the universe? Yeah,
Benedict? I can answer for that one. Global industry is around 179 billion for the gaming market. Philippines contribute around 1.38 million, which is just around 0.008% of the entire global market. In terms of animation, we contribute around 20 to 30 million, but the global market is around $270 billion. So there's around 10,000 workers in the animation sector, but they're doing mostly outsourced work. So the goal of the CCP right now is to stimulate original IP content development program, which is to really encourage Philippines to start creating, to tell our own stories.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Benedict, go ahead, Rianne.
Yes, actually for Tuldok, our mission vision includes the development of IP, original Filipino content, to further boost the Philippine creative economy. So it's really a very good opportunity for us to get this grant from CCP because we were able to push through for projects like this.
Yeah, I was going to mention to make a distinction whether you're pushing the works will be under a Filipino brand or be like made to measure OEM, outsourced artist work for foreign production outfits like Walt Disney perhaps or Marvel. So we want to build the Filipino brand. We're clear on that, right?
Yes.
All right. And how hard do you imagine that task is? Because right now the names that we know of are all, they all became big because they became part of the global brands. Like you've got Mikey Sevilla, who worked on Encanto, which is a Walt Disney project. Armand Serrano, also a big name, only because he worked on Mulan, Lilo and Stitch, Tarzan of Disney. Will Sportacho, we had him on ANC before. He became big because he drew Batman for Marvel. So what's the potential here? And what is the challenge? Is it going to be an uphill climb to make it big as a Filipino brand? Let's start with Benedict and then Rianne.
If you look at this, this program that we proposed with the CCP started 12 years ago when we were working with Information and Communications Technology Commission during President Gloria's time. Mm-hmm. So the idea to really help the ACG sector has been that long, 12 years. But I was before just a policymaker supporting bureaucrats. Mm-hmm. But now that I'm one of the decision makers, I really push the board to pursue this angle, because at the same time, we're not just helping original content development, but we're helping the outsourcing, the money-making sector as well. Mm-hmm. Because if you want to promote overseas, you need to have a portfolio to show. The Philippines has a lot of good stories to tell.
All right. And, you know, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. Rianne, can you give us maybe your best work that we can be proud of? So what work would you say, if you were to display, you know, Filipino brand and talent to the global stage, which work would you say that is?
Well, I think we should go back to our roots, our Philippine folktales. In as much as I want to say one particular, which I can, because I'm currently working on one, which is Bernardo Carpio. But what I can say is that through this initial efforts, I am hoping that we pursue original Filipino content using our own, folktales, graphic novels. I mean, Hollywood is already doing those in the foreign creators' works. Why not adapt our own? Who will make for us? It's going to be us. It's our own sensibilities, our own roots. Why not push for that? Mm-hmm. I think we deserve to promote that.
Mm-hmm. Benedict?
If you noticed, Michelle, recently we had Trece in Netflix.
Yes.
So it was based on comics, then it moved into manga, which was now manga or anime, which was produced by Netflix. Mm-hmm. So there's really a potential opportunity. But the challenge now is to create a sustainable original content development industry. So that is the goal of the government, is to pump in. Right now, we're pumping in $20 million, or around $400,000. But this is just a seed money, hoping that the future legislators, after the elections, will take notice in this industry. Mm-hmm. That, yes, there's a lot of potential, especially for the youth.
Mm-hmm. I imagine, Benedict, Rianne, that the goal is that you don't preach to the choir, that the Filipino content we produce here will be, you know, will become big on the global stage, not just for Filipino viewers, but for foreign international viewers as well. Is that the goal?
Yes.
All right. Rianne, I'm very curious, is there money in this industry, or does the impression of starving artists still hold true today?
I really believe that it's a two-way thing. Of course, in a start, being artists, we tend to rely on grants like this, but once we, like now, we are almost done with our projects and we are looking at the phase two, like maybe getting more funding opportunities and make this profitable, because it is possible. We have mobile app development, which is, you know, something that we all use with our mobile phones. We want to produce some games, and we have an augmented reality component for our comics. And I really think there's great potential for us to eventually earn from this, despite the fact that we started with, you know, a grant that's considerably passion projects. But I really think that there is a great future out there for us.
The future is looking wonderful. Benedict, final question. What else can the government do for this industry? I mean, we're seeing a leadership change in 3 months. What do you think can the government offer beyond the grants?
So basically, it should be a two-pronged approach. Number one is institutional capability building. So it's really supporting, giving training to all this workforce. Actually, the Department of Trade and Industry initiated a program to support animation and computer gaming industry. So the DTI launched this program just last March. Secondly, we need to have human capability capacity building support, which is really through grants, and maybe through this, it's gonna help convince the private sector to put in more money. Because at the same time, we have to look more outside. We have to be more global in our approach, and to have our stories to be more universal.
And to have this whole industry just sustainable. Rianne, final word from you. What do you wish from the next government? What kind of support does your team need, aside from the ones Benedict mentioned?
Yes, I think it's very ironic how people hinge on the arts as a coping mechanism while we were on lockdown. Mm-hmm. Yet the artists who made these works were called, you know, not essential, which I think needs to be better dealt with, as we may not be giving medical care or providing the generally expected basic necessities in life. But even in our direst moments, we often hang on to the arts, things that touch us, things that are emotional, as part of our survival, because deep inside, that's what makes us human. And as an artist right now speaking and looking forward to have more projects with the government, I really hope that they will support the creative industry, the creative economy, because the future is there. So we really hope that there will be more projects for us, not just for grants, but, you know, policies that will really help us develop better policies on taxation, develop more opportunities for us to engage, not just locally, but internationally as well, through maybe film markets, etc. Mm-hmm. So there are lots of possibilities out there, and we want to build a Filipino brand. So we want to be known as Filipino artists creating Filipino content.
All right. On that note, Rianne, Benedict, it was a pleasure speaking with you guys. Good luck. And for those who are interested, Benedict, they just have to go to CCP's website?
Yes. Visit our Facebook page as well. It's going to be posted in our YouTube and our Twitter and Facebook and Instagram accounts.
All right.
The official website of the CCP.
Benedict, you're going to have to come back on the show once the winners are announced. For the
grad. Yes, it would be sometime late June.
All right, looking forward to that. Thank you, Rianne and Benedict. Have a great week ahead.
Thank you.
All right.
Have a good day.